In this learning module, we will consider the ways in which Spotfire 3D scatter plots may be used to visualize data, including the ability to examine the relationships between three continuous variables and rotate the view in an effort to evaluate the position of markers within three-dimensional space. As we consider the 3D scatter plot, please be aware that this visualization is useful not only for viewing three dimensions of data which describe points which represent positions in actual three-dimensional space, such as this conical haystack on the left, but may also be useful for taking any three measures and identifying outliers or cluster groupings in those three dimensions. The real value of Spotfire 3D scatter plots is realized when you rotate the plot to change your perspective on the data and truly appreciate the three-dimensional nature of this visualization. We'll do just that in a demonstration which uses a Spotfire analysis document in which a 3D scatter plot has already been configured. Use Open File in order to locate the example with Interpreting 3D Scatter Plots in the title. Click Open and agree to the terms and conditions of use. In this example, we have conducted a benchmark survey of 268 companies and collected various measures such as productivity, number of employees, sales, growth, and profit margin. Each company is identified by an ID number, which allows them to remain anonymous, and the company is assigned to one of five company types. Our main interest is centered upon these company type categories and how they relate to the continuous measures of sales, growth, and profit. Therefore, a 3D scatter plot has been created on this page, which displays growth values increasing in this direction along the x-axis, sales values increasing in this direction along the y-axis, and profit values increasing as they come out of the screen at us in this direction along the z-axis. In addition, the color by property reflects the company type to which each of these anonymous benchmark companies is assigned. Now, it's time to take advantage of the primary value afforded by the 3D scatterplot visualization type, the ability to rotate in order to view the markers from different perspectives. There are navigation controls available here, which will allow you to turn the 3D scatterplot incrementally right, left, up, or down. However, you may find it easier to rotate the plot using a keystroke and mouse combination. With your cursor held over the center of the plot, hold both the control key and the right mouse click button. When you drag the mouse in different directions, you can see how the 3D scatter plot rotates corresponding to those movements. Rotating in this dynamic fashion may allow you to discover such things as outliers. Note that this company has a high profit, but low growth and low sales values. You may also discover clusters. Note that this grouping of companies have high profit, high sales, and high growth values. If you find yourself becoming disoriented with regards to the positional interpretation of a rotated 3D scatter plot, look for the intersection of the three axis lines. This is the position in the plot where all three measures are at their lowest. Then, as you follow any of the lines to the label at the end, the position of markers represents increasing values for the measure indicated by that label. Using this approach, we may notice that all of the education companies, identified by green markers, are grouped in this region of the plot, which indicates low profit, low to moderate sales, and a wide range of growth values. Service companies, identified by yellow markers, also have a wide range of growth values, but have a very narrow range of both sales and profit, both of which are toward the lower end of our overall range of values for those measures. Transportation companies, identified by orange markers, appear to have a somewhat broader distribution of sales and profit values, but they are entirely separated from the sales and profit values for the technology companies, identified by blue markers. In addition, the technology category appears to be devoid of any low profit companies. As you rotate the plot, you may lose value labels at the end of an axis line, off the edge of the plot. You can use the zoom out icon on the navigation controls toolbar to zoom out. However, there's also a keystroke and mouse combination which can make zooming more fluid. Again, with your cursor held over the center of the plot, hold both the shift key and right mouse click button. When you drag your mouse backward and forward, the 3D scatter plot will zoom in and zoom out. If you want to reset the navigation to its original orientation, you can use this icon at the bottom of the navigation controls toolbar, or right-click on the plot and select Reset Navigation. In addition to these navigational capabilities, you may also use the other interactive features afforded within the Spotfire analysis environment. For example, you may notice that this technology company is separated from the cluster of other technology companies. If we click on that marker, it becomes marked, and the Details on Demand panel will display all of the data associated with that company. Click where there is nothing in order to clear that marked value. We may also use the Filters panel to isolate only certain company types. Notice that the removal of data from the visualization may result in a rescaling of the values based upon new maximum and minimum values along each axis for the filtered data subset. Additionally, you may wish to trellis categories of interest in order to maintain a shared common scale across those categories while you evaluate the distribution of values in the three-dimensional space separately for each trellis panel. If you rotate this trellised plot, you will notice that all trellis panels will respond to your navigational commands. The clustering of these company types in certain regions of the three-dimensional space, as well as any outliers which do not conform to those clusters, may be more easily viewed in this trellised configuration.